What's going on, folks? It's me, Mikey Pipes. I got a very special service call coming up to show and share with you guys. But first, the limited edition, the Mikey Pipes 2025 version 2.0 posters. We're almost out. We're at 118 of 150. Remember, folks, 100% of all proceeds go to the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy Charitable Organization, where we provide free or low-cost plumbing, heating, cooling services to those of the community who can't afford to hire a professional. There are only $42.50. Zelle, Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, Gold Bullion, Bearer Bonds, you name it, we take it. And it's for an amazing cause. Ain't it beautiful? I'll even autograph it for you. Are you ready for today's service call? Let's go!
Good.
No worries.
So I understand you have no heat. Well, who has no heat?
Me. I don't know if they have any upstairs now as of last night.
Okay.
You want me to text them?
Yeah, you can. I have to get down there, though.
That's
hi. When did the heat stop working?
Two days ago.
2 days ago? Okay.
So sorry.
That's all right. All right, emergency service call, but they haven't had heat in 2 days. None of the the zone isn't on. It's hot. These are two future zones. The return is ice cold. We have 20 psi of pressure in the boiler. And the target is 180 degrees. And right now it's pre-pump P-2. Like there's not a call for heat because that circ isn't on. Why isn't that lit up? Bad circ or not getting a signal to turn on? Let's see if there's voltage. 120 volts. But the light isn't on. I don't feel nothing. It's hot. This is cold. Why isn't that light on? Let's see. Weird that it's not lighting up. So we have these two future zones here. I just disconnected the line voltage going to this circulator. I'm plugging it to here. Let's make sure we don't have a wiring problem. I did check my meter here, but let's just see. Maybe the circuit there went bad. I want to see if that lights up. Yeah, see? We got a problem with that circ. Let's take advantage of the future circs that we're not using and take the head off. The one that we need to use that's defective. And
do a little switcheroo here. At least, no need to give them a brand new circulator. If they're not, I just want to go in there. There we go. No need to give them a brand new circulator when there's two brand new ones sitting right there. You know? Just saying. These lever connector wire nuts, fancy stuff, bro. Fancy stuff. Okay, let's get the cover back on, open that up, open this up, get the air out, and be good to go. Okay, I got the air out. Come on. Boot up, baby. There you go. Stand by. Here we go, folks. There you have it. Hot. Mucho caliente. Mucho caliente. All right. We are now circulating water. We're going to watch this bad boy fire up. Our target temperature is 180 degrees for copper fin tube baseboard and cast iron convectors scattered across three floors. 86 and climbing. Good numbers. Excellent. Okay, let's get our Sharpie, mark that dead, today's date, put it back there, have a nice day. All right, folks, some key takeaway points to remember. Customer's complaint, no space heating. Primary zone, circulator, dead. You'll still have domestic hot water. That's one of the great things about having a tankless combi. You could have a space heating problem, but likely still have domestic hot water, so. Space heating was dead because the zone circulator was kaput. When we installed this several years ago, there was talk of, hey, I may add two more zones, or we'll zone the house. So we added two more zones for future use to the system. Why spend hundreds of dollars right now to replace that dead circulator when we have two others sitting right there that have never been used, water has never been introduced to it. They're basically brand new, just been sitting there for a couple years. And we got them up and running in under an hour.